results confirmed from and my colleague Sri Sanjay will also fact and labor and today the cases which were confirmed, two of these passengers Goa. Okay. So those two passengers have been confirmed. Then we have four cases which are confirmed. That brings our total number of active cases in Goa as of now. See, our labs are functioning throughout 24/7. All our labs are being told to 6 PM is the time that we will freeze the results at. The tests keep going on throughout the night. Whatever are the results of that, we will definitely include it in our figures for after this press conference. Now today we had sent a total of 500 and in facilities, etc., and suspects under hospital isolation are 5. So these are the basic figures that I wanted to share with you. Just for your information, I want to mention a little bit about our testing protocol because there seems to be a little confusion among certain sections of the media regarding what protocol we are following. Our testing happens with the help of two different types of technology: screening test, and the other is the RT-PCR confirmatory test. The TrueNAT screening test is the first test that we use for the people who are coming by rail, for the people who are coming by road. We first take them, if they are coming through the North Goa district checkpost, we take them to our Asilo hospital where their swabs are taken. Similarly, if they are coming through the checkpost of South Goa district, they are taken first to our Hospicio hospital, their swabs are taken. After the swabs are taken, they are immediately moved to our quarantine centers, the various residencies, you are aware of that. And then the testing is conducted using the TrueNAT screening test. Now, if a case comes positive in the TrueNAT screening test, the protocol as prescribed by ICMR is that it has to be sent for confirmation test at the RT-PCR lab. Our RT-PCR lab for the state of Goa is our lab at Goa Medical College. So only after the confirmation happens at Goa Medical College do we declare a case as confirmed. This is the protocol nationally followed. Now, the labs that we have, apart from our virology lab in GMC, which is the only lab for confirmatory test, but the labs where we are doing the screening test are Asilo, Ponda District Hospital, Ponda Sub District Hospital, Chikhalim Cottage Hospital, Hospicio District Hospital. These are the four labs where our tests are going on. As I mentioned to you, because of the need to test each and every passenger who is coming in by rail, by road, by air, we have literally started functioning all our labs 24/7. Swab collection already had begun 24/7, but now we are also doing the tests through the night, through the day, 24/7, in shifts, of course, of the lab technicians. Once again, that there are no rapid tests being done in Goa at all. In fact, rapid tests have not been initially a strategy, but then ICMR issued clarification that rapid test kits are not to be used, and we are not using any rapid test kits. Rapid test kits are the blood sample-based test kits which give you the result in 5 minutes or 10 minutes. We have not used a single rapid test kit right from the beginning of COVID crisis. Not a single rapid test kit has been used anywhere in the state of Goa. The protocol that we have followed for train passengers, just a couple of words on that. You know that we had two trains which had come in, Rajdhani trains, on Saturday and Sunday. Apart from this, of course, we have trains coming every day. Every day we have trains which are not terminating in Goa. They pass Goa in transit, but the last two trains which terminated in Goa were the Rajdhanis which came on Saturday and Sunday. Now, the protocol that we followed for that is each and every passenger swab was taken at a Hospicio hospital, and then they were shifted to quarantine. Now, depending on the results of the tests, we have been discharging the people. We have been allowing them to go on strict home quarantine of 14 days. For the air passengers, the protocol is quite similar. Today was, of course, our first aircraft which came in specifically with passengers. You are aware that we had 414, 41, 417, 417 passengers who came in. Details, of course, will be shared by my colleague. I'm only explaining the protocol. The passengers who come, we screen them. We take their swabs at the airport itself through our smart kiosks which have been installed in the airport, as well as our other teams of paramedics as well as doctors who are deployed there at the airport. Swabs are taken and they were tested. They are being tested in both Chikhalim and Hospicio labs. And then as soon as the swabs are taken, then they are shifted to the paid quarantine facility that they themselves have chosen. So in this case, since they came as a group from Italy, therefore the company itself has decided which are the paid quarantine facilities for them.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Those swabs are taken for TrueNAT testing or?
The swabs are taken for TrueNAT testing when it is used for screening. These are the passengers whom we are screening through TrueNAT.
At the airport also you are doing TrueNAT?
Yes, we are taking the swab to test it using the TrueNAT technology. When we send it for confirmation, if at all we get a positive result in the lab, we have to take a fresh sample and then send for confirmation to GMC lab. I would also like to just mention about our preparedness at the ESI, the COVID hospital. We had 100 beds to begin with at the COVID hospital. Ever since we started having fresh cases, we have increased our capacity to 170 beds. So to that 100, we added 70 more beds. And now our plan is to increase it by further 50. So the target is 220 beds. 100 plus the 70 plus 50, 220. 170 beds are ready. We are planning to increase it to 50 very soon. There are sufficient ICU beds and oxygen beds. The Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has asked us to pay equal emphasis and in fact more emphasis on availability of what is called oxygen beds. Beds which can have oxygen cylinders attached to them so that the patient can be given immediate oxygen supply. The experience around the country and the world has been that the first option should be to give them oxygen supply. Only if that fails should we shift the patient to ventilator. We also have a dedicated pediatric ward at the COVID hospital. And our team from ESI hospital, from our DHS, the district hospital of South Goa, Hospicio Hospital, and our consultants from GMC are all part of the COVID management team at the COVID hospital. To ensure the safety of all the staff from police, from revenue administration, from the various departments who are manning our border posts, as well as those staff who are helping out every time we have arrival of trains and the aeroplanes, we have taken a decision to provide face shields. You know that face shields have been already used by quite a number of people who are involved in COVID management. It's an effective measure of social distancing as well as safety. So we will be providing, we have already in fact gone ahead and placed the order with the approval of the State Executive Committee for 500 face shields for the personnel of North Goa district and 500 face shields of the personnel of South Goa district. As Secretary Education, I would just like to mention that as you are aware, the 12th standard exam started today, 10th is starting from tomorrow. Chairman Goa Board and Secretary are here. They will be addressing you after this, so I will not go into any details. I only want to mention to you that MHA, the Ministry of Home Affairs, has given exemption after an application was moved to MHA by the state government. And MHA has given us a go-ahead to conduct the exams subject to certain conditions which we are already following and putting in place, including social distancing, including the provision of sanitizers, wearing of masks, thermal screening of the students, etc. All details will be shared by Secretary Goa Board as well as Chairman Goa Board immediately after this press conference.
Hi, good evening friends, and today we had two flights which have already landed from Italy. They carried 168 passengers each. Third flight is expected to land at between 9:30 to 10:30. So total 417, as ma'am has said, seafarers would come, would arrive in Goa, and after the testing they have been shifted to the quarantine facilities as has been by the MHA guidelines. Regarding movement of trains and migrants, I want to share with you that since 29th April, 3,847 people have arrived in Goa and 32,860 people have left Goa by 11 trains which we have sent. Around 13,448 passengers have gone to different states. Three trains have gone to MP, J&K, two and Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, UP and Chhattisgarh. We are making all possible arrangements to facilitate the movements because these our friends who now wants to go home, and we are facilitating it as much as possible on basic law and order situation. I just want to share the data, our daily law and order situation report till 4 p.m. today. We have booked around 7,361 cases for spitting at public places, and we have challaned 14,501 cases or people for not wearing mask. These are details. Thank you.
Any proposal to stop any railway halt in Goa?
The Honorable CM has taken up the matter with central government. We are yet to get any final decision on it.
At a border checkpost, ma'am, the police personnel, have they been provided with PPE kits now?
You see, PPE kits are to be used in a particular hospital setting. We have already, as I mentioned to you, face shields for the police separately. We have already provided 100, and another 200 are on the way. They'll get it by tomorrow. But they have to, of course, maintain the basic safety protocol, the masks. We are also, in fact, exploring the possibility of giving them non-hospital grade coveralls. The coverall that can be worn as a gown on top of their uniform. Not only for the police, for that matter, all the staff who are there at our border check posts. We are coordinating with a couple of well-minded organizations in Goa who want to sponsor it under their contribution, voluntary contribution or CSR. So we are definitely exploring that.
Ma'am, on Saturday, three people came from tested positive, who came from Calcutta. Mm. That day, 17 personnel, including police, were exposed to these people. Was anything done? All these people got
quarantined? Yes, we immediately got the staff of the GST department, the border checkpost personnel, as well as the police personnel tested. Fortunately, they have all tested negative. We don't have any problem with regard to them.
Ma'am, do you find any problem when you talk about testing, especially when this huge amount number of people who come by train and all? How it is in a day or something? Is it a problem to get them a whole lot tested or whatever?
No, it is a challenge, but it's not a problem. It's a challenge that we are very well equipped to meet. The days when we are expecting a large number of passengers, our entire team is put and deployed. For instance, on Saturday, Sunday, when the Rajdhanis came, we had around 60 teams which were readied. In fact, we got less numbers than we expected on the first train. And then, of course, the second train, we got more numbers than we expected. So, basically, we are prepared for it. The only thing is that, yes, it's a challenge in terms of keeping our technicians 24/7 on shift. It is a challenge to the district administration to coordinate their movement. But definitely, it's a challenge that we are more than well prepared to meet.
Because today, even CM said that leaving that Saturday and Sunday train, which would be not be allowed to halt, the other trains would come and all. So how would you be taking care of it?
You see, the other trains, that is a part of the national policy on movement of people by trains. So we have even managed the bigger numbers of Rajdhani. It's only that, you see, we are concerned that the number of cases in Goa should not increase. That is why the request has gone from Honorable CM side. Whatever be the decision of government, we from health department and our administration will be fully geared to meet it.
Ma'am, some train passengers are having a complaint that a report are being given late, too late, I mean to say. So, how you see for it?
That is where we need the support and cooperation of the passengers also. This is being done for their own safety primarily, and then the safety of their family members, and third, the safety of our entire society as a whole. We request them to be patient. We require at least some hours to run the test. And then the results are done. As I told you, we are performing 24/7. So we are doing the best that we can. So a little patience, a little forbearance with us. It is for their own benefit. It's for the benefit of their family and for the benefit of Goan society as a whole that we are testing them. Yes.
Are you prepared for the May 25 airports opening up across the country? Some days Dabolim will also open. So what's your strategy?
We will follow the same protocol. We will not take the passengers out of the airport without swab collection. So we have enough facilities at the airport to manage the swab collection. We'll collect the swabs there. Then according to the protocol for international passengers, they are supposed to be quarantined for 14 days. I believe that the Honorable Minister for Civil Aviation has announced that the protocols for domestic flights will be issued very soon. We'll have to just wait for the protocol and see what is being stipulated by the ministry. We will be making preparations accordingly.
Do you think 200 beds then would be enough, because obviously the numbers of people coming in will be more.
Yes, we do have a plan B as well. We have definitely projected to the future. We are not going to rely only on our ESI stroke COVID hospital if the numbers increase. We have our plan chalked out for how to expand as and when the requirement is. Let me also share with you that we are hopeful about our patients who are currently in treatment at COVID hospital to also get better, because hardly a couple of them are symptomatic. The rest of them are all asymptomatic. So we repeat their test. If we find them negative, then twice over, then we immediately shift them to our institution quarantine for 7 days, and then we will allow them to go on home quarantine. Same protocol that we followed for our first set of 7 patients who were positive. So this is going to be a cycle. Patients will come, but patients will also be treated, cured, and discharged.
Madam, government is taking over any private facilities to have as an additional COVID hospital.
You see, certain private facilities have already been requisitioned by the respective collectors, long back in fact. So those are there. The district administration has already planned for it.
And
yes.
Madam, two questions. Yes. One is the immediate challenge, the next challenge on the COVID part is that to prevent community transmission. Is there a plan in place? What is the DHS coming up with? And does the government have a kind of a scientific advisory handling this strategy? Because,
you see,
because
yeah.
You can't just rely on these central guidelines that come in this, because there are a lot of local conditions that need to be taken into account.
Yes.
The
next challenge is not community transmission. The next challenge is local transmission. There are 3 levels to this. One is what we are currently at, imported cases, where each and every person can be traced back to a place outside Goa and they have traveled in. And we are testing them. Let me reiterate that Goa is the only state in the country which is testing each and every person who's crossing our borders, either by road, rail, or air. So that protocol ensures that we get to know immediately upon their entry that they are positive. The next level after that is local transmission. As you have seen in the rest of the country by now, local transmission is when the people who are positive transmit it to others in the locality. Now that happens only if you don't detect them early on. And you know that COVID is very often, the COVID infection is not symptomatic. So then when a positive person, without even realizing that he or she is positive, interacts with family, interacts with community, that's when you have local transmission. Community transmission is the 3rd level. Direct link to a person who is positive, there are cases which are coming up. So our immediate challenge is not community transmission, it is local transmission. Local transmission, we are making every endeavor, as I've just described to you, that we are making every endeavor not to have even an instance of local transmission. If we continue this protocol of testing each and every person who's coming in and we detect them at source, so to say, we will be doing enough to take care of that. The ministry's guidelines are always very helpful, but you are right, each state also has to evolve its own guidelines. For instance, you are aware that the ministry has a fresh set of discharge guidelines, but we are sticking to our earlier guidelines of the ministry where you test twice and then you discharge the person.
Ma'am, Port Town is the main entry point. There is a 2, MPT and the airport. So it is an entry point of all the, through the ship or maybe by the flight. So special arrangement, something has been done over there?
You see, when we initially got to know that Government of India has permitted seafarers to come by ship, we immediately made the provisions for the testing kiosks to be set up at MPT. 4 testing kiosks are there even as we speak. But so far, we have not had a single case of a ship which is docked at MPT. All the seafarers who have come into Goa so far have docked at Mumbai, and from there, after their testing etc., they have come to Goa. But our facility which we had set up there, 4 testing kiosks remain there, because we are still expecting that sooner or later we'll start getting ships which will dock there at MPT. Now the protocol for arrival at port is the following. The people who are there, the seafarers, they will deboat, they will come disembark onto shore. Their swabs will be taken. They will be going back to the ship till the results come. Once the results come, they can be shifted to the quarantine facility, the paid quarantine facility, where again they will have to be in quarantine for 14 days. And God forbid if somebody tests positive, then we will follow the protocol for their treatment. So this is at the MPT. But airport I've already explained, so I'm not repeating that. Provisions have been made in both places.
What was total number of quarantine facilities?
Total number of quarantine facilities, you see all our residencies, all the GTDC residencies are by now quarantine facilities. Apart from that, we are collectors have requisitioned private hotels. The exact number of quarantine facilities, yes. So the number would be anything between 25 to 30. I'm adding on the private hotels also, which are being used as quarantine facilities. I have the total number of people who are quarantined. We have currently 777 people who are under quarantine. They are spread across various properties. All our GTDC properties, as I said, those are the places where we are keeping people under institutional quarantine. Then, of course, the seafarers who have come in from Mumbai, they have selected their own paid quarantine. Today, the air, the passengers from Italy who came by air, they have chosen their own quarantine facility. But of course, that list is shared with us and we maintain a close watch on whether quarantine is being followed or not.
Madam, in terms of numbers, what is the numbers that Goa can keep in quarantine right now?
That is a number which depends on the willingness of hotels to give their rooms as quarantine. You see, right now, as I told you, there was a point when we had quarantined at least 1,500, 2,000 odd people earlier. Right now, as I told you, currently undergoing quarantine is 777. So, it is an expandable number. In fact, the tourism department has put in all efforts to identify enough rooms. We have rooms spread across both the districts. The master list is maintained by tourism department. I don't think rooms are a problem as of now. Paid quarantine facilities are readily available.
Madam, one last question from my side. See, there's this protocol where when you test them for TrueNet as they arrive, if they test positive, then you send it for a confirmatory test.
That's right, yes.
What happens with the negative cases? Because globally, TrueNet is known to show up a lot of false negative.
No, not TrueNet. You're talking about the rapid test. TrueNet, in fact, is a very validated technology. TrueNet is not a technology which is being widely used in the world. Number one, India is one of the first countries which have used TrueNet. So far, the experience with TrueNet throughout the country has been very positive. The false negatives have been thrown up by the rapid antibody kits. Many of them are used, many types of them are used. Some of them are effective, some of them are not. But in India, as of today, ICMR has advised against using the rapid antibody kits. The problem that you are mentioning, it remains that you have to repeat this confirmatory test. What we are doing is, till we get the confirmatory test, we are keeping all the close contacts, all the people in fact who came into contact in quarantine. To just give you an example, when the Rajdhanis came in, we took the swabs. The moment we got a TrueNet confirmatory, in fact, we kept all the people under our watch for that reason. The moment we got a TrueNet confirmatory, the screening positive, immediately, the people who were there in that same coach were isolated. They were quarantined. It is only after the confirmation was received that we have started discharging people. After completely sifting that category to see that not a single person who came into contact leaves our quarantine. This is what we are doing as of now. And just to give you an idea, ICMR has also approved the TrueNet confirmatory test now. So that will be a huge blessing for us because that will cut down our procedure of taking the swab again and sending it to GMC. They have just got the permission, the same company which is providing the TrueNet kits to us. They have just got permission from ICMR, approval for their confirmatory test. Now they are awaiting the drug license from Government of India. Once they get that, they will be able to manufacture those kits. That will make our life easier.
Ma'am, yeah. I just want to ask you one thing, is like how much help it has been from the Ayurvedic medicines? Like because yesterday the Ayush minister said that another 15-16 days time we could have a medicine, full-fledged medicine from Ayurveda. You know.
The Ministry of Ayush has said that there are some formulations okay. which can be used as prophylactic. So there are homeo formulations. Yeah. There was an entire Ayurvedic protocol. If you recollect, we had circulated it in every home, in every household during our house-to-house survey. That was a protocol circulated by the Ministry of Ayush. So whatever directives have come from the Ministry of Ayush regarding alternative medicine systems like homeopathy or Ayurveda, we have shared widely with our public. Arsenic albumin, which is a prophylactic homeo medicine, is widely distributed even today through our PHC and CHC network. And the Ayurvedic protocol, we have, it's like a what should I say, a living style, certain things that you need to do as part of your daily life. Those protocols were circulated to each and every household during our...
My question to you, sir. You have mentioned about the offense, about the mask and that for the splitting. So how much will be the fine and what the amount has been collected, generated?
As far as fine imposed and collected, since we started these all actions, cumulatively our fine is 58,77,000. So since this lockdown has begun, we have collected this much. It includes all cases of challans and this lockdown violations. So this is the amount, 58,77,000.
Especially for the mask and split.
We are collecting 100 rupees per case, and you can multiply these numbers accordingly.
So migrants train ka kuch migrants labor hai na wo log kitna bacha hua hai abhi tak?
In our portal, around 1.25 lakh people have registered. So we have sent around, as I shared, 32,000. So not all of them may leave. So we expect that around 70,000 more people will are expected to leave.
So some minister bol rahe the ki agar West Bengal ka minister se accept nahi kar rahe, uske liye abhi tak kya report aa raha hai wahan se?
अभी तक हमारी जो इंटर स्टेट मूवमेंट सेल है, दे आर टाइंग इट अप एंड हमारी जितनी भी ट्रेन्स हैं हम उनको यूज़ कर रहे हैं, और हमारे जो सिस्टम में जिन्होंने रजिस्टर किया है, वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग देम थ्रू एसएमएस इंफॉर्मेशन एंड वी आर सेंडिंग द पीपल टू द स्टेट्स वेयर एवर दे हैव ऑलरेडी बुक द ट्रेन.
सो अदर स्टेट से कैसे रिस्पॉन्स आएगा ऑफिशियली?
नो, दे आर इन कॉन्टैक्ट एंड अकॉर्डिंगली दे आर सेटिंग अप द ट्रेन्स. So okay. We are in touch with most of the, including West Bengal, I want to confirm. Our interstate movement cell is in touch with them, and they are working out the timings of the train and how it should move.
So border sir, pe ye kar rahe the ki border pe non goan ko stop kiya tha, abhi kya start karne ke liye chalu kiya
hai? Currently we have movement pass system, transit pass. According to that only people are being allowed, and these information which I have shared with you, they are based on that passes. So we have a permitted category, especially Goan, and they are allowed, and that's why I said till now 3,847 people have entered since 29th of April.
Well, so, Arogya Setu, that showing 46 cases confirmed. You are saying 43.
You see, Arogya Setu app is not getting the up-to-date details. We have raised this problem. There are initially there is a discrepancy of three cases which has always been there. ICMR has corrected its data, but on Arogya Setu that discrepancy remains. We have taken it up with the ministry. We have officially communicated. कौन सा? वो आरोग्य सेतु सेंट्रल ऐप है, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का. तो पूरा जो पोर्टल है वो वहां से जाए. Yes,
so
Goa Port is having a separate
response. Sir, I wanted to ask you one question. Coming to interstate movements, if there is a delay from the other state, will Goa government make arrangement to send migrants, make a train arrangement, or will you rely on them till they make arrangement?
No, as I said, till now our hands are already full. People who have registered, the state governments have deposited money. We are sending the people, and other states are contacting, our teams are contacting them. They are also receiving their people from other states. So this is a continuous movement. I don't see that this situation
there has been delay from two states, West Bengal and Bihar.
No, I see that, as I said, ke based on our discussion, what we have, I have with the interstate movement cell, these things are being worked out and things are being planned. Train will be planned as soon as we move. Initially, we had this, there was some restive movements among the UP migrants. So that's why their trains have been prioritized. Now they are leaving soon. So accordingly, whenever we have this contact with the full details with the West Bengal worked out, we will be sending trains to West Bengal and Bihar. We don't see any problem.
Is there any plan to hike this fine for face mask from rupees 100 to?
No, till now we are sticking to this one. We don't have any such plan.
Ma'am, will you be able to elaborate slightly on your statement that you have sufficient number of ICU beds, oxygen beds? Could you elaborate with figures about that? And,
yes.
And secondly, I also wanted to ask you about complaints that we keep receiving about the ink used for stamping for quarantine patients. So initially, when this issue cropped up, the director had informed me that the ink will be changed and that it has been changed. But today we received another complaint, just a very similar complaint about skin infection. So I wanted to ask you whether,
I'll address the second question first.
Yes.
You see, we have not received any complaints since the day we changed the ink. We had asked for a fresh supply of ink through our chief election officer. Only the election officer is competent to order vials from the factory in Bangalore, the manufacturer in Bangalore. Ever since we got, from Mysore, sorry, not from Bangalore. Ever since we got that fresh consignment, we replaced all the existing vials with those. And to be honest with you, right from that day, even yesterday I checked with DHS, he told me we have not received any further complaint. If you have received a complaint, please pass it on to us. We'll definitely look into it. We did have some instances of those skin irritation and allergy reactions. And that's why we decided to change the entire set of vials of ink. Coming to your first question now, we have 40 ICU beds in the COVID hospital. That is expandable to around 60. Oxygen, the beds where we can have an oxygen cylinder connection are as much as 130 as of today. Now, oxygen cylinder is something, it doesn't require a whole lot of preparation to have an oxygen cylinder connected. So, we have enough supply of oxygen cylinders across the state of Goa. If the COVID hospital requires more cylinders, we can always arrange for it. We are maintaining our stock. So that's why I made the statement that as far as ICU and oxygen beds are concerned, given the ratio that we have to always keep in mind, we are comfortable. Yes.
Madam, at the COVID hospital, the oxygen distribution is centralized or is it individual?
You see, centralized oxygen, you will have a centralized oxygen system, but then you need to have individual oxygen cylinders for the patients. So that is a number that I have in mind.
Ma'am, how many ventilators are there?
Yes, ventilators. Now we have around 16 ventilators in the COVID hospital. And we have a total pool of around 100 odd ventilators across the state. We had placed orders for 200 ventilators. There was a global shortage of ventilators, you're aware of that. Now the person with whom we have the firm with whom we have placed the order has assured that in the next week, he will be giving us 25 ventilators. And that subsequently every week, he will be able to provide 25 more. So by July, he is saying that he will be able to fulfill our entire order of 200 ventilators.
Okay. Right. So any arrangement for the Nepal migrants?
Our immediate team the team which we have a nodal officer who looks after the issue of foreigners. He is tying it up with the association and the MEA. And as and when the things are finalized, we will let you.
Okay.
Just one last question.
Yes.
There is a lot of posts which come from quarantine centers where people are not happy with the bed sheets, the rooms. So what is your department about?
We have a cell which is monitoring all these grievances, all these complaints. Whenever we get information, we are immediately alerting our teams. We have a team for each quarantine center. It's a mix of people drawn from different departments. We have people from the revenue administration side. We have people from our medical department side. So it's a combined team. We alert the team and I think we have been addressing them as and when we have received information about any genuine grievance. Thanks a lot. Thank you.